Hey, this is just a very quick follow-up to the last video, where I was asked about some suggestions of what to play on the Steam Deck. I don't want to turn this channel into Watch Mojo, but I didn't feel like this needed to be a super long video, so here are 10 games you might want to check out on the Steam Deck. They may not be the most graphically intensive games, but they sure are a lot of fun. So, let's get this countdown started. Oh my god, is that a wizard? In at 10 is Temtem. Temtem? Is that game for babies? Yes it is, that's why I'm recommending it to you. A fun monster collecting game that tries to remove as much of the randomness from the battles by utilizing a stamina setting instead. It has a story and a rival that will make you despise their guts. They mean, they scream, but most importantly they spoilers. As a quick heads up, this game is online only, but it can be played entirely in co-op, which is worth it. I play with everything set to the highest settings and the frame rate limited to 30fps, which gives you nice visuals and decent battery life. At 9 is Sonic Robo Blast 2. This game is a blast! 2. Run, jump and do hedgehog things. A fun look at how one of the Mega Drive games would play if it was in 3D. It's available to download from the Discover App Store in the desktop mode of the Steam Deck, and the game is based on id Tech 1, which powered the first two Doom games, so it'll run fine. It is a hard limitation of the engine to cap at 35fps though. A non-mover at 8 with Danganronpa. Murder mystery fun with compelling cases and a colourful cast, this game stands head and shoulders above its contemporaries. Quite a violent game that doesn't really leave much to the imagination, and with some of the finest humour noir that will really catch you by surprise. This game is basically cardboard cutouts, plus it has a native Linux port so it runs all the better. Would also recommend the second game too, as it's more of the same. Down at 7 is Forza Horizon 4. You are competing to be the best at car, getting the most amount of car, getting the most amount of medals. I usually play on low settings at 60fps as I think the extra frames are needed in a game like this. This definitely hits battery life, but vroom vroom. At 6 it's less of a game, more of an experience. No Man's Sky. Explore planets, build things, get killed by random plants, see what's out there in this procedurally generated universe. Game does stutter from time to time and some users have mentioned occasional crashes, but I play on medium settings with FSR enabled to squeeze a few more frames out. Midway at 5 is Final Fantasy 7. Game's a classic, you know that, and I definitely recommend playing the original game on anything you can. It's really worth a play for the message it tells, beyond the hee-hoo, it's me, Sephiroth. It's a story of environmentalism, rampant capitalism, even if the gameplay is a little janky, you're more in it for the story. There's no real settings to set here, the game runs at like 15fps, so it don't matter. And to those who think it's weird that I'm saying to play this game, there are still people out there that haven't played it. I didn't play it until a couple of years ago even. Up at 4 is Doom. Is this the original, or 2016 one? Yes? No? Both? It's a gorgeous and fun, if gory, game. You'll have a lot of fun ripping and tearing through this one. Whoa, did you feel that? Do whatever you can to get this game running at 60fps, it'll help you enjoy it all the more. I put as many things as I can to medium, but turn textures down if things are getting a bit wild. Going for bronze is the Spyro Reignited Trilogy. Fun 90s adventure game reimagined. The game is absolutely stunning to look at. Go and collect things, play minigames, it's harmless fun. The game looks great, but the high resolution textures will make the Steam Deck chug a bit, especially since you won't really be able to notice the difference on the small screen. In the penultimate position is Dragon Age Origins. Quite honestly, the best RPG I've ever played, and the closest a game has ever come to replicating the Dungeons & Dragons experience without the icky need for friends. It's a bit janky in the gameplay department, but it's BioWare, so let's just be thankful it works. Enjoy the story as you basically make it as you go. The end goal is the same, but the way you get there, it's anyone's guess. This game definitely isn't demanding, but the animations and cutscenes are locked to 30 anyway, so this one's up to you. And your number one is Disco Elysium. Oh damn, this is a great game. It's up to you to solve the murder of a soldier, but everyone in the town pretty much hates you and doesn't want to help. In fact, you hate yourself too, because the past you did something to completely mess your brain up. You don't remember anything, so you gotta talk to people and solve problems. The art style of this game is gorgeous, and the dialogue is absolutely poetic. Although, the game deals with themes of nihilism, suicide, and just bad things in general. It's still a great piece of art. I play with everything on the highest settings and frame rate limited to 30fps, especially since a lot of this game is reading slash listening to dialogue. Honestly, if you don't play this game, you're a stinky doo-doo head, and you know I don't just throw those kinds of words around for nothing. Well, that's it for this silly little video, but thank you all so much for checking out the last video. We were really blown away by the response, and a little scared, but it's okay. We had a few videos in the works already, so I'm going to use this opportunity to give you a quick sneaky preview. Next up, I'm going to be working on a review of Sonic Frontiers, as a friend was bullying me to do it, and I want to check out this crazy story we've heard so much about. My colleague Mr. Turnabout will also be dropping by to provide some input, as he's really quite excited for it. Actually, he already did a video going over that here. This will also be our first proper video in HDR, as I've been experimenting with it recently, so look forward to that. Speaking of Mr. Turnabout, he's currently working on a video about Amphibia. He's personally a huge fan of the series and wants to go about deconstructing it a bit. I haven't read his entire script yet, because I'm currently making my way through the show, and I don't want to spoil it, but if he's even half as positive as I've been on it so far, then you're in for a treat. Seriously though, what is it with kids' cartoons these days and just hitting you like a train right in the gut? Sprig, I love you, buddy, but there's only so much emotional torture I can take in a day. Yes, 3 more episodes, please.
You belong at the bottom of the socioeconomic barrel with me!
Finally, our yearly Crimbo Bash is coming up, and this time we're going to be hosting the first annual Dreary Middle. Sure, we'll recognise you, awards, but we'll be talking about our favourite things from the past year and giving them a little trophy. So hopefully that's all something to look forward to over the next couple of months, and we hope that you enjoy what we have to offer. I said this a few times in the comments, but we are here just to make the videos we want to see and talk about the things we want to talk about. Of course, we are open to suggestions as we like to try new things all the time, but at the end of the day, we're just two friends talking about our favourite things. If that sounds like fun to you, then you're welcome to come along. Anyway, thank you again for watching. I've been Monotilla, and this is Dreary Middle.